मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द बीएमसी ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन क्लास। माय सेल्फ इज मिसेस अर्चना डे फ्रॉम इंग्लिश स्कूल। दीज आर आवर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिसर्स, मिसेस स्नेहलता डुमरे मैम। नोडल बीट ऑफिसर इज मिस्टर शरद पुराड़े सर। आवर नोडल एचएम इज मिसेस मैरी पुष्पम पॉल। Our assistant nodal HM is Mrs. Manpriti Kaur Anand, and our CNO is Mr. Ratilal Kishan Gurgule sir. Okay, so students, before start our class or our lecture, start our day with the good talk. Okay, now the screen. The roots of the educations are bitter, but the fruits is the sweet. Okay, what do you mean of this thought? Means root of the education are bitter. Bitter means, do you know the meaning of the bitter? The root of the education are bitter, but the fruit is sweet. Means now you take a good education time, so that time you feel like that, what is oh my god, how much study I have to do, one lecture is finished, second lecture is there, how much homework is there, I'm getting bored, I don't want to study. Like this we can say every time when we are studying. But that time, if you are study, that time you feel very, means bored and no, I don't want to study like this. But if you study that time, you are not get bored, then you will get your future bright. So that is the meaning of this thought. The roots means, when if you take a education good in hard efforts and a good way, means you will get the bright and the good future. That is a means fruit is a sweet. You understand the thought? The roots of the educations are bitter, but the fruit is a sweet. Okay. Now, students, before start our lesson, do you know this? Still there is a cold outside. Yes, and one superman or superwoman or whatever is seen in the picture is fighting with the corona. So still we have to follow the instruction given by our government and our society. Okay, now look at the picture. Can you see this picture?
Maharaj Shivaji Maharaj.
Yes, Shivaji Maharaj. So students, last year you in the fourth standard you learn about the history of the Shivaji Maharaj, right? You can learn about the Shivaji's life history, birth of the Shivaji Maharaj, and their Swaraj, all related to the Shivaji Maharaj, right? So student, tell me about means history of the Shivaji Maharaj was before the 4 years ago, or the time 4 years ago. Means we can say this is a happened in the past. Okay, so the science tells the events about the past, and last year we learn about this history about the Shivaji Maharaj. Okay,
what so is this?
In the first lecture we learned already about that. Now this is a revision lesson. Okay, now look at the screen. I am asking, showing you some questions on the screen. Okay, so you can give me the answer of the question, one by one. Raise your hands and okay. First question: where was the Shivaji Maharaj born? Your options are Shivneri, Raigad, Pune, Bijapur. Yes.
Pune.
Where was Shivaji Maharaj born?
Shivneri.
Yes, very good. Shivaji Maharaj was born on Shivneri. Okay, good, very good. Now next question: which Maratha Chan did Shivaji belongs to?
Bhosle.
Yes, very good. Bhosle. Shivaji Maharaj belongs to Bhosle Chan. Okay. Now the next questions are: what was his mother name?
Jijabai.
Yes, right. Very good. The name of the Shivaji Maharaj mother is Jijabai. Okay. Now next question: who was the Shivaji's guru?
Samarth Ramdas.
Yes, Samarth Ramdas was Shivaji Maharaj guru. Okay, so these things you learn in a fourth standard, right? So can you see on the screen? You can see there is a some words are given. Can you tell me words is related to what? means when we are using these words, now, today, tomorrow, after, sometime, this year, next year, yesterday, sometime ago, now. Can you tell me when we are using these terms of the word? For what purpose or what to tell the people? When we are using these terms of the word? Yes, right. We are using this term to tell about the time or if anything happened. Means suppose, for example, today you are having holiday, tomorrow you will have a school, or tomorrow yesterday you went to the garden, like this. We are using these words to tell the about the time, right? So for our convenience, we divide time into the this way: today, yesterday, tomorrow, this year, next year, sometime ago, now, after, sometimes. Okay, so you understand. For our convenience, we divide time into the these terms or these words. Okay, so student, time that has already gone a past, that is our past. Okay, means the event work was already done in the past, in the time. Means time is passed away, that the past, and time that we are in now is present. Means now our history lecture is going on. This is our present, okay? Time that is yet to come is our future, okay? So the science tells even about the past, that is a history. Now look at here, can you see the some sentences are there?
Yes.
Okay. So I will read one by one and you will tell me about that sentence, that which sentence is related to the past, future and the present, okay? So first one, I shall write an essay. Yes, tell me.
Future.
Yes, right. Then second one, Ben will sing a good song.
Present.
Again, see now, Ben will sing a song.
Future
tense. Yes, right. Then I shall work hard to obtain a good mark. This is also the one example of the future tense. And remaining two, that is my father will go to the California, become a good person. These are the example of the futures. Okay. Now second, look at down. My son lives in London. Now tell me, this is a what past, future or a present? My son lives in London.
Future.
Is it future? My son lives in London.
Past.
Look carefully. Otherwise, look at the second sentence. She plays basketball. She plays basketball. Which she is playing. So, what is it? Present, future, or past?
Future.
Okay. Future.
She is playing plays basketball. Okay, I'll tell you. Playing activity is going on means she is playing now. Now means it is a present. She is doing the activity, right? And my son lives in the London means still he is now in London, he is living. He is not, means he is not leave the London and come to the India, but she is now, he is my son is living in London. For example, he goes to football every day. Means every day he is playing football. He goes to football every day. Means so he to football, play football, okay? Loves to play basketball. And he loves to be present. He loves to play the basketball. Understand? So these are the examples of the future and the past, future and the present. Now next we will see, these are the examples of the past. He met his wife 6 years ago. They watched a movie yesterday. She didn't the library. The police didn't find any clue. I become a teacher 2 years ago. Okay. The past. The student, most we in the last EVS lecture that a science is tells about the event of the past and history is related to the past event. Means whatever has happened in the past, that history tells us. Okay. So what is the history? Many events that have already take place, that is the past, and the past is related to the history. the many events that have already taken place, that is our past. Understand? Now look at the picture. Can you see in this picture? You can see, yes, one small child that is there, then a little bit grown up, two kids are there, and the third picture you can see grown up girl and the boy. Can see, okay? The student to understand the past concepts of the history. You can see if you are 10 years old today, means now you are 10. Look at the picture between the 10 years, 10 years above. So, if you are 10 years old today, so event of your birth take 10 years ago. Look at the child, 10 years to go to the back, that is 86420. Means, if you are 10 years old today, so event of your birth take place 10 years ago. Means, birth is a past, your past. 10 years similarly you are in the present, and similarly after the 10 years now you will be in the future, that is you will be in a 20 years old. You understand? So past, your childhood is your past, that is your history, and now 10 years old is your present, and is your 20 years when you will become a 20 years old. So children, so science tells the events in the past, okay? Means about the event, what happened in the past. Understand? See, there are the different types of the scientific of the history. Okay, so time between two your birth is past. Past means the special characteristics of all the science is there, is that their fact can be tested, experiment can be repeated any time. Different tests to determine whether the evidence is reliable is called a scientific. Okay? Do you know subject means there are lots of subjects our syllabus. Every subject having the methods, right? Means how to understand the concepts, how to solve the maths, or how to solve the short answers, how to solve objectives, etc. All these. So we know the every scientific methods or some different methods. Same the science also have scientific method. Can you see child is there, and you know we all are the kids, right? Means directly means all are like you and me, like, okay? So you. There are many things happen in our childhood, and that may not know about you now. And you can remember other things what happened in your when you're small, kids, 1 or 2 years. Can you? Is it you recall all the memories or some incidents was what happened in your childhood? Can you remember now? Come on, tell me. No, can you remember? Childhood or years. Now you remember these things? What happened in your childhood? No. No one remember what happened in childhood. Can you see there is a picture? Can you see the picture? Yes, anyone of you tell me? See in this picture? No problem. I'll tell you. There is a, you can see her on the left side, grandparents and grands are there, and the side your parents there, okay? So our grandparents and parents often tell us about the story about our past, okay? When we grown up, our grandparents and our parents often talk about the story of our past, and we examine and the past. What is the story which happened in the past? That is our memories. And we find the difference in their narrative. Okay? So grandparents is telling, telling way different narrative. Same story. While their writing skill, their factness, or their telling it, both are different. So we find present. Storytelling by the grandparents and storytell by the our parents. So what we have to do? What history is doing? Mind the details of narration carefully. Okay. Examine. We have to listen. We have to carefully listen about the what is the details narration and then decide the correct the fact. Means story tell by told by our parents is correct or story told by our parents is correct. So you have decide what correctness of that. Okay. Correctness of the whether it helps us to take from other that is the scientific discipline. Okay. Can you see the picture? Yes. You can see a picture. There is something going on there. Some soldiers are there and some village people are there. Okay. So what there is there villagers and something is going on there. Okay. Something is arguments is going on. So it is not possible to conduct the experiment. It is happening here. You can see on the screen. Can this event happen again? Same people are there. Same soldiers are there. No, this will not happen again. Methods of presenting history is different from all the other sciences. Means when some events happen, that time, possible that event happen. Example, suppose today is heavily raining in our Mumbai. Okay, so it is not again happening the tomorrow. Our climate department or geographical department is saying that this today there is a 24 hours heavily rainfall in the Mumbai. So tomorrow again same news is there or same situation was will there the situation will change. So it is methods of presenting history different from the other side. Understand you? Yes, all students understand. Okay.
Yes.
Now see. Okay. Now you can see history has a uses
yes,
the sorts of at every. Namely, while looking for collecting the evidence. Okay. Evidence means what? Evidence means proof. Right? So, examine the evidence while putting it together. Help is also taken from other science. And that is why history is considered to be the scientific discipline. Okay. So, can you see on the screen? There is a different types of events was taken or passed. And study this all the events we need the scientific method. Okay, history is considered to be the scientific discipline. Means history has a scientific discipline. For example, you have a discipline when you come to the school, right? You have to wear the shoes, wear the uniform, clean and neat and tidy, and you have to follow the instruction of the school teachers. Discipline is there, punctuality. So same way, history also considered to be scientific discipline. There is a discipline in the history, and that discipline is related to the scientists, scientific reason, scientific ways. Okay. Now see, history is not written on the basis of the imagination. History is not written on the basis of imagination. Can you see the picture? Children, see the ancient object, the sculptures, pot, coin, inscription, copper plate, bookmark, book, manuscript, traditional song, traditional stories, remembered by many generations are the sources of the history. Okay? Means, suppose, for example, anybody see now for at the starting of the lesson, I asked you about the what do you see in the picture. So you all are answer that this is a Shivaji Maharaj, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. So how you know this is a Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj? So the written sources of the Shivaji Maharaj or the many things which was found by our historical science put into the together in the one book or one method. To learn about you the history of the Shivaji Maharaj. So on the basis of that books or basis of that all the material is related to the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj help you to learn about the Shiva history of the Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, so these are all are the ancient objects help us to learn of the history and learn the history. Okay, you understand? Children, now see, there are different signs in our surrounding. Like, right? You know, the different signs are there in surrounding. Like, environmental science is there. Then physical science is there. Biological science is there. Lots of science are there. And all the sciences having their own nature, own characteristics, own properties to adapt the surrounding, adapt the whatever is going on the surrounding in the nature, right? So history also includes three parts. That is the material sources, written sources, and the oral sources. Okay? The study of the science help us to find the answers of the many questions. Okay? There are many sciences available in the surrounding. So students, skin, any individual and collecting action of human being have consider as a consequences. So the result in the environment may be either favorable or unfavorable. Look at the screen. Material sources, written sources, and oral sources are the three sources of the history. Means on these three sources we can find out the what is the history. Understand? The help of the evidence that stands this test, and this is a scientific method. Okay, so history is related to the three basic concepts. Now we will see history and us. Okay, history means what is the relationship between history and us? Look at to the screen. Can you see the picture?
Yes.
First one. Yes, tell me what you see in the first picture, left side of your, sorry.
Side yes. Of the first picture.
Say loudly.
Ma'am, first picture is our past.
Yes, first picture is our past. Means you can see there are a different people is fighting and soldiers are there and many people is doing the something is wrong. Okay. And the second picture. Tell me in the second picture. Okay. The second picture you can see one person is standing there. And some people are sitting there quietly and they are listening to that person. Okay, right? So student, any individual and collective action of the human being have a consequences. So favorable or unfavorable. Okay? Understand? Means?
Yes.
These two pictures, one picture is they are doing something wrong, and second picture they are doing quietly and calmly and they are listening to that person. So sometimes what happened, some situation is either in our favorable or either in our unfavorable. So for the progress, also progress of that all the situation is depends to help the society progress. Okay, now see. Here is the picture. You can see the people of the village. People are there. Can you see? Right. The people are sitting there, and the some people are standing there and telling to the people about the something related. So what happens, students? When we study history, we get to know about the people of the village work together. Means if you, when you come together and work, it. Another and you are helped to one and each other, then your work will be a good. Okay, so village make goods and the whatever is there. For example, suppose your class, you are in a fifth standard, and HM is telling you that you have to put the surrounding at the time of your PT lecture. What you all do, you get together and you can clean the surrounding, right? Not one person is doing the do and clean the surrounding, right? So same thing, which when the we all are work together and with a proper manner, proper discipline, then our village or our work is way good and the better, right? But in the you can see in the second picture, some people are arguing, right? You can see their faces. They are doing a angry and they are shouting and they are not listening to each other, right? So when these types of obstacles come in the way of the development, so development cannot be happened. Means that work is destroyed, that work is not going on the path. Understand? So history attempts to find our out answers to many questions by studying the way of thinking of the past societies, their actions and the consequences. And the study of the history make it possible for us to study what is and what is not favorable for the progress of the human society. History thus provides us with the guidance about how we should behave today in order to shape our future. Understand? Once again, I'm reading, history's attempt to find out answers of too many questions by studying the way of thinking of the past society and their actions and the consequences. The study of history makes it possible for us to study what is and what is not favorable for progress of the human society. History thus provides us with a guideline about how we should behave today in order to shape a good future. Understand? For example, as now everybody know the COVID is outside, right? Still we are fighting with the COVID. Now the almost 1.5 year is over and we are still fighting with the COVID. First wave is come, that time we don't know how to behave and what to do and how to tackle with this situation. But when now after 1.5 year, we know about how to tackle the COVID, what precautions we have to take and how to avoid the things which will give the way to the COVID like this. So when we are in the year, 1 year ago, 1 year back, that is our past, that we don't know how to tackle with the COVID. But now in the present, we know how to tackle with the COVID and for future, we are planning how to stop COVID to enter in our society and how to get to the less patients in your future, right? So this is also the history. You understand what is the history? Okay. Now see, can you see the pictures on the screen? Yes or no? Yes. Okay, I'm telling you. By studying the history, we get to know about the good and the tech and good tech took place between our own and the own civilization. So what we learn in the history, by telling us, history is telling us about the life story of the great peoples, that take that took place. History also serve to inspire the motive as us. Means history is telling us the life stories of the great peoples also, and some in the history that also motivate us today to don't do the same mistakes. Okay, so student, look at the pictures. By studying the history, we get to know about the give and the take place between the other civilization. Okay, can you see the picture? You can see in the first picture, lots of the peoples are there, and these peoples we can find nowadays. Okay, and the second picture you can see some peoples are there. Start from the one and the end of the. So we also know how the people way of the life went on changing. Right. So history also with the help of history, we know that the way of the life of the people or the went to change. Means starting, you can see the pictures, how the person is looking, then slowly, slowly he gets to knowledge and he gets his way of the living, and slowly, slowly, gradually they increase their way of life and changing. And then lastly, you can see the person like you and me, like, understand? Okay, now see science history. Look at the pictures. Can you see the pictures? Yes, Indian people fought against the British government to get the independence. You, me, and everybody know that in the past, Indian people fight against the British government for the independence. Means they are fighting for the independence, get the independence, and this is a historical action. Okay, this is a historical action. So after fighting with the British, India become an independent nation on the 15th August 1947. You're listening to me, right? How after fighting with the British people, India became an independent nation on the 15 August 1947. And we can say that independence was a consequence of an action. Okay? So what we say, independence movement was a consequence of action. Okay? Now see, student, every city, every village, every country, every state has its own history. You understand? Every city, every village, every country, and every state have its own history. Okay? So everything around us is own history. And the past, look at their past event of the today on past event, and the future depends on correlated with each other. This is a continuous chain with each other, and that is Indian people struggle for the independence. Okay, so in this way, event of the today are linked with the past action. Okay, means you can see the past. We learn that the man begins to make a tools from the material available in the nature. You and me, everybody's learned that. The man began to make a tools from the material available in nature. Then slowly he get the knowledge, and he increase he used to find out the discover the fire, and then many more things he discover, invention of the today, invented the wheels, and then slowly get the technology, use of the technology, invention. They can find out the new things in the surrounding. Like, so student, we realize that the future depends on the past, and this is what we learn from the history. Okay, so we learn about the past, future, and the present. So our past is related to the present, and present is related to the future. So this is a chain, and we cannot break this chain. You understand? So next generation added to this development technology, improve this invention, and this invention only possible on foundation and discovery of the past. Okay, you understand? Means next generation means your generation added development technology into the invention, and this invention only possible on foundation and discovery of the past. Okay, we cannot go ahead, means we cannot get the good future if we don't know our history. Okay, so history is give us to become our future bride. You understand? So student, this is our lesson, what is a history. Now listen, what we learn in the lesson history. First we learn about the past and the present of the future history. Then we learn about the scientific methods of the history, and how our sources of the history help us to learn about our history, that we learn in this lesson. Okay, and then we learn about the history and us, means how our history is related with us. Means if everything around, everything us is having something history. You understand? So we learn in this lesson about the history and us. Then we learn about how the next generation added to develop the technology with the help of the history. And then we learn about the invention and technology of the present, right? So student, you understand this lesson. This is our revised lessons of what is the history. Now it's time to your homework. See, this time I am giving the something different homework. Okay. Now see, what is the first question? Collect the information about our freedom fighter. You and me and everybody know who are our freedom fighters. So I only give the two names, that is Mahatma Gandhi ji, and second one is the Jawaharlal Nehru. So what you have to do, you have to collect the information about your freedom fighter and write the information in your notebook. And if you're possible, then you can stick their pictures also. Okay? You understand? This is your first question of the homework. And second question is, collect the pictures of our different types of sources of the history. You know what are the sources of the history. There is a written sources are history, oral sources, and one more sources. What is the third one sources? Come on, tell me. What is the sources of this? Oral, written, and the yes, oral, written, and one more thing is there. What sources of the history? Come on, tell me. Tell me what are the sources of the history? Written material and the oral, right? So you have to take a collect the picture. You can find out pictures from the internet or the Google form, and then collect the pictures of the different types of sources of this history and stick in your notebook. Okay. And the question number 3, make a drawing about the 15 August celebration in the old days, means in the old days, in the past. Okay. Not now. You can go to the internet and search out. You will find out the pictures of the old day and make a drawing of that. Okay. So children, you understand the homework. I hope you understand the lesson which we learn now. What is the history? If you have any doubts, any questions, you can ask me and take a screenshot of the homework. Okay. So student, thank you for watching and listening my lecture. If you have any doubts, anything, you can tell me or ask me. And still you have to stay home and stay safe, because now it's September is going on. First September is there, and the third wave of the COVID is entering in our country also. We can find some patients in some states or some cities also. So all are stay home and stay safe. Don't go outside, especially the you all are the children. Okay. And tell your parents to get as soon as possible to vaccinate yourself, and please don't go outside the home. So thank you for listening my lecture. Okay.
Thank you. Have a good day.